there are car launches and then there are Bentley launches, and I'm here in San Francisco for the launch of the new GTC Speed Convertible. I'm going to be driving one of these things all the way from here to Las Vegas. Yes, it's a tough job, but someone's got to do it.
This £168,000 drop-top Bentley not only looks gorgeous, but its 6-litre W12 engine has 616 brake horsepower and 800 newton metres of torque and is good for 202 miles an hour. And I had the pleasure of testing it over 1,000 miles in a variety of conditions, ranging from the parched desert of Death Valley National Park to the sub-zero snaking roads of the Mammoth Lakes. However, my first destination was San Francisco's most stunning landmark, the Golden Gate Bridge. It was time to get the roof down.
Well, I'll tell you what, this is a little bit of a treat, isn't it? You know, got a beautiful sunny day. I'm driving over the Golden Gate Bridge in the world's fastest four-seater convertible. And that's the thing with this car, you see. Yes, it can do 202 miles an hour. But if you just want to cruise around at 30 miles an hour and take in the view, it's perfect for that too.
Leaving San Francisco and the Golden Gate Bridge behind, I headed inland towards Sacramento. En route, I encountered some equally stunning, if not quite as famous, bridges. Yet despite having lowered and stiffer suspension than the normal GTC, in comfort mode, the speed model still glided over the expansion gaps just like a Bentley should. My next destination was Lake Tahoe, which is situated 1,900 metres above sea level. But when you have 800 newton metres of twin-turbo 6-litre engine at your disposal, you don't really notice inclines, even in a car that weighs around 2.5 tonnes. Really, the appearance of pine trees was the only indication of the increasing altitude.
Well, so far I've done about 200 miles though. If I'm honest, this car is so comfortable that it feels like I've only done 20. And I've arrived now at Lake Tahoe and it has some absolutely spectacular scenery. I mean, just check out that view. Right. That's enough of that because I want to show you another view I've been enjoying today. Have a look inside the car.
The Continental has a fabulous handcrafted interior, and with the roof down, everyone can see the exquisite attention to detail. The speed model gets some unique interior trims to set it apart from the rest of the range, and because there's decent room in the back, four people can enjoy this luxury in total comfort. After Lake Tahoe, I headed down from the mountains and then back up some other mountains towards Mammoth Lakes. And as the sun started to drop in the sky, so did the temperature. It was time to put the Bentley's well-insulated roof back up as day one drew to a close.
Okay, so it's day two of our epic adventure and we're at Mammoth Lakes. It's below freezing, but I don't care. I'm gonna put the roof down anyway because I've got a heater that can go up to, well, furnace levels. I've got a special vent behind the headrest there which will blow warm air around my neck, keep me nice and cozy. I've got heated seats down here which get so hot you could use them as a form of male contraception, if you know what I mean. So I'm probably gonna be all right. See you later. Well, we're out on some windy mountain roads now, and it's testament really to the car's capability that you kind of forget just how big and heavy it is because it actually corners really well. We've got loads of grip from the four-wheel drive system, the steering, it might not be the last word in feedback, but it points the car exactly where you want it to go. And quite frankly, you can hammer along here at quite an alarming rate, really. If I have one complaint, when you go over a bump, the steering wheel does wobble in your hand a little bit as the chassis flexes, and that's a problem you don't get on the coupe version of this car. But do you know what? That's a small price to pay for being able to take the roof down and, well, enjoy the fresh air.
And being able to enjoy the fresh air also came in handy as we left the cool of the mountains behind and headed down into the Californian desert and its seemingly endless arrow straight roads. Eventually, I came to Death Valley National Park. Situated 86 metres below sea level, it's the most barren place in the whole of the United States, and therefore the perfect place to test the Bentley's performance.
Obviously, the key talking point on this car is its 202 miles an hour top speed. But there's some other performance stats you need to know about. For instance, 0-60, that takes just 4.1 seconds. But perhaps more impressive is 0-100 takes just 9.7 seconds. So in theory, if I was to stop and then floor it and count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, I would in theory be doing 100 miles an hour. But of course I wouldn't do that because that'd be very, very naughty.
As the sun started to set, I left California and headed into Nevada and onto my final destination, Las Vegas. The classy Bentley, a stark contrast to the gaudy bright lights.
Well, I finally arrived here in Las Vegas, and what an epic journey, and what an epic car. Now, I'll admit it is rather expensive, but considering what you get, I think it's worth the money. All I've got to do now, though, is figure out where to get the 168 grand to pay for it. Now, there must be a casino around here somewhere.